So do you remember how this was kind of dipping down and I wanted to oppose it from the bottom by having something of an opposing shape? It's still happening, but that shape isn't down here anymore, is it? It's here. I'm going to have a little bit of light rounding out the top of this focal area. This being darker, it'll help to frame it in and get rid of this this plunging feel, I think. I hope. So I'm going to change tracks now, and I'm going to go to cobalt blue and raw umber. I've got a pretty warm sky there. To that. Okay, that'll be a little cooler now. And I don't want the shape to be too direct. And I don't want little bits in my paint. Little bits of paint skin. Sometimes working into a pile of paint, if it's been sitting for a day or two, you'll have little parts of that pile that'll begin to form a skin, and then the brush picks it up, and that gets a bit messy. Add a touch of alizarin crimson to that mixture. Make it a little more purple, that warms it up a bit. Okay, so you can see what I'm doing with that. I've put a little more light on the sun now. Or coming from the sun, rather. I'm gonna try to get the sort of icy fog look to this painting. Even though these are warm colors, we'll see how it goes. Anyway, I just thought I'd explain my reasoning here, and I'm just going to carry on and do the labor of cutting in with various grays around the rest of the sky, and we'll get back to you once that's in and we start working on these hills.